if I'm not sleeping, it's either because I'm thinking about microbial ecology or because my baby is awake, one or the other. It's either baby or microbiome. I study wild microbial communities, and these communities are incredibly fascinating because they're very diverse. They contain hundreds to tens of thousands of different microbial species, and these species come together and interact with each other in the environment to form this complex system. Microbiomes provide very important functions for their ecosystems. For example, they recycle nutrients and carbon and make those elements available to other creatures in the food web. And so what we're concerned about is that we don't quite understand all of the important functions that microbiomes provide, and also we don't understand how those functions will change or even maybe be lost given changes in the environment. And this is really important because of global climate change. We want to understand the stability and resilience of microbiomes in the environment. And so what we hope to do is use these sequence data to try to understand the microbial community as a system, and then to understand how that system responds to disturbances. The way that we have to study these microbial communities is actually indirectly. This is because the majority of those taxa cannot be grown in the laboratory. And so we'll go out into the environment and we'll sample the microbial community. We'll like take a swab from the leaf, or we'll collect a core from the soil, and we'll be very careful not to let our microbes from our human bodies contaminate that sample, right? And then we bring it back into the laboratory and we lyse open those microbial cells and extract their genomic material. And then we use sequencing to understand who those microbes are and what functions they can potentially be contributing. We do that by a process called sequencing. And so what the sequence data are that we get back is kind of like a detective's code. So we get all these different pieces, and by assembling them together in the way that they go, we start to understand what those genes are and what functions they provide. And that's where ICER comes in. That's where the high performance computing cluster is important for my research, because we have to put these codes together from the microbial sequence to understand what their functional potential is, and we can't do that without really wonderful compute resources.